Our eyes can only see so much, and without the aid of the technology that we use today, we may not discover this world of living organisms right under our noses, figuratively and literally. I've started teaching at this university, and it was one of my assigned courses to instruct. At that time, I study and teach microbiology because, as I have said, it was part of my job. Eventually, as I studied and prepared for the lessons that I was supposed to teach, I was able to really appreciate how beautiful and important the discipline of microbiology is. Microbiology is the study of tiny living things that are much smaller than spiders, mosquitoes, or ants. These living things are so small you can only view their cell walls or their flagella through a microscope. When you're in the field of microbiology, it's like you have this unique ability, a superpower, to see what most people cannot. You deal with living organisms with a size of 1 to 2 micrometers long, growing, replicating, and dying. When you understand how these microorganisms grow, you can control them, and sometimes even kill them. Well, of course you need to sterilize your equipment and avoid an outbreak. This leads us to the importance of microbiology, specifically in food. This branch of science is the very foundation of food safety and processing. This is the reason you can eat samgyeopsal with cheese without having an upset stomach. Why? What has microbiology got to do with Korean barbecues? Well, cheese is a product of fermentation, a process that microorganisms are really good at. And as for the meat, well, we cook those for a reason. Firstly, we're not savages. And secondly, we don't want to end up in the bathroom at 2:38 in the morning. Knowledge of microbiology helps us to avoid food poisoning. But I am aware that this isn't the easiest course to study, and several students may have had a challenging time going through this. But I believe that studying microbiology can save the world, in more ways than one. People in the field of medicine devote a huge chunk of their time to master this field, because one day this could mean life or death for his or her patient who has an infection. And as food scientists, it isn't much different, because on our part, we are tasked to create safe and wholesome food for the community. And learning microbiology would help us achieve that goal. And as I ponder over these things, teaching all this to students and seeing them grow, seeing them practice food technology has been really satisfying and fulfilling. It makes me happy when one of my students approach me to say thank you for imparting something, either if it's about food science or about life. It's really heartwarming to make such an impact on others. This is just one of the many fields and careers in food science and technology. We're going to cover a few more of them in the following videos, so stay tuned and subscribe. This video is in collaboration with Food Science PH. Make sure to check their site if you want to know more about food science and technology.